this video, we're going to cover the 6 different analysis techniques that allow for us to determine reasonable pricing and define the purpose of proposal analysis. FAR 15.404-1 states, the contracting officer is responsible for evaluating the reasonableness of the offered prices. To accomplish this, one proposal analysis technique, or a combination of 2 or more techniques, may be used to ensure that the final price is fair and reasonable. The contracting officer's objective is to negotiate a contract of a type and with a price that provides the contractor with the greatest incentive for efficient and economical performance. When we conduct analysis on pricing, we have to be sure to buy only from responsible sources at prices that can be determined to be fair and reasonable. Each contract must be priced separately and independently. Contractors are not allowed to include contingencies in their pricing, such as the outcome of ongoing negotiations with the labor union. While the FAR does not define what constitutes a fair and reasonable price, it does establish specific steps that we need to take in order to determine prices proposed as fair and reasonable through proposal analysis techniques. A price that is fair to the buyer is one that reflects the fair market value given the prices of market transactions between informed buyers and sellers under similar competitive market conditions. A price that is fair to the seller is one that must be realistic in terms of the seller's ability to satisfy the terms and conditions of the contract. A reasonable price is a price that a prudent and competent buyer would be willing to pay. The 6 proposal analysis techniques that allow us to determine fair and reasonable pricing are price analysis, cost realism analysis, technical analysis, unit pricing, and unbalanced pricing. Price analysis is conducted by evaluating the total price proposed by the contractor. Price analysis may include evaluating data other than certified cost or pricing data obtained from the offeror or contractor when there is no other means for determining a fair and reasonable price. In this example, the individual cost elements are not going to be examined. Instead, we're going to evaluate the total contract price of $251,114 using the price analysis techniques provided to us in paragraph B of FAR 15.404-1. When we conduct cost analysis, we must look at the separate cost elements as well as the profit or fee. Cost analysis shall be conducted on cost reimbursement contracts and may be done for fixed price contracts. In this cost analysis example, you can see the breakdown of each of the cost elements. The direct and indirect costs are first calculated and added together for the subtotal costs. Then, the general and administrative cost is calculated by multiplying its rate times the subtotal costs. The FAR definition of price is cost plus fee or profit. In this scenario, there is profit, so profit is added to the total cost to arrive at the total contract price. When we conduct cost analysis, we should not do so in a vacuum. When appropriate, we should rely upon the expertise and resources available to us, which includes technical experts who can conduct a technical evaluation of the proposed pricing, the Defense Contract Management Agency and/or the Defense Contract Audit Agency, and the weighted guidelines as required per DFARS Part 215. Cost realism analysis shall be conducted for cost reimbursement contract types and may be used on competitive fixed price contracts. The purpose of cost realism is to determine the most probable cost by evaluating the individual cost elements. We must ensure they are realistic for the work to be performed, reflect a clear understanding of the requirement, and are consistent with the technical approach. The contracting officer should request that personnel having specialized knowledge, skills, experience, or capability in engineering, science, or management perform a technical analysis. The purpose of technical analysis is to determine the need and reasonableness of the proposed resources, which assists the contracting officer in determining the overall reasonableness of price or cost. The minimum requirement for technical analysis is examining the types and quantities of material proposed and the need for the types and quantities of labor hours and the labor mix. Pricing at the unit level needs to reflect the value of what is being procured for each line item. Any method of distributing costs to line items that distorts the unit prices shall not be used. For example, distributing costs equally among line items is not acceptable except when there is little or no variation in base cost. For non-commercial requirements where there will not be adequate price competition, the contracting officer shall ensure the solicitation requires offerers identify in their offers those items of supply that they will manufacture or for which they will not contribute significant value. At the line item level, each price is evaluated to ensure it is reasonable. Pricing at the line item level is considered to be unbalanced when the price appears to be too high or too low. This slide shows us an example of unbalanced pricing. The offeror's mobilization costs appeared high and should be validated to ensure they reflect those costs needed to allow the offeror to fully perform at the beginning of the contract. Another issue found with unbalanced pricing is the costs associated with the base period are much higher than those in the option periods. The costs in the base period should reflect what is needed to perform in that period and not future periods. The last issue is a common one for follow-on contracts. The incumbent contractor knows what items are ordered the most in an IDIQ and can use that information to its advantage in a competition. The incumbent may increase the pricing of the items that are ordered the most and then decrease the pricing on those items that are not ordered on a frequent basis. In summary, we have learned about the 6 proposal analysis techniques. One or a combination of techniques must be used to determine reasonable pricing.